clearly not. Oh, I was going to drop off Flame Guard. I still want to drop off the Saint's Shield, though. Because I don't particularly need it. But Feather and Restore Fatigue, not really necessary. And drop off this. Maybe I can't drop off this Tower Shield as well. Yes, I can. There we go. May you walk on warm sands. Hello, Philosopher. How's it going? Yeah, so off to Vivec now. Yeah, well, after almost a week-long shoulder injury, I'm doing quite a bit better. My shoulder's still a little on the... It's happened again. My shoulder's still a little on the rough side, but I can sit at the computer fairly still and stream. So it was about time I streamed again. I'm not entirely sure what happened at my shoulder. I just woke up one morning and it was feeling really like stiff, like I had sprained it. And I didn't think too much of it at the time. It was awkward, but I figured, well, I'll probably be able to sleep it off. But then come the following day, it actually got worse. So, yeah, not entirely sure what happened to set it off. So maybe I just slept awkwardly and then just repeated sleeping. Just continued to aggravate it. It has happened before, like, must be a couple of years back now. Yeah, it does happen from time to time. I do think it's got something to do with my bed, but considering my other back problems, my considering my other, I guess I'm having a swim now instead. Considering my other back problems, this bed is the best bed I can have for it. I've tried other arrangements, and this arrangement actually lets me sleep comfortably. Yeah, that's the the second time I've clipped through something today. So, if I have shoulder issues once every couple of years because of sleeping in this particular bed, then if that's the trade-off, I guess that's what I'm going to have to put up with for the time being. Yeah, I mean, I don't usually have problems with the collision in this game. Every once in a while, I'll find myself in a rather stupid situation, but it's usually of my own making. But yeah, since returning from Solstheim, I've been getting more just sort of clipping issues in just general gameplay, so yeah, not sure what's going on there. Right, now we need to find...
Probably nothing.
Milo. She's not here. So she must be in her... Well, maybe she's in her quarters. If I can remember where her quarters are. Well, I've done the main quest of Blood Moon, yes. In fact, It's been Let's a couple of odds since I've returned to Vardenfell. Yeah, just trying to think where I'm where I'm at in the YouTube space at the moment, because I think we just started getting into my previous it's on the other side of the
Go ahead, Outlander. What do you need?
Complex here. Yeah, I think we just started dipping into the previous stream. Don't get this map. I'm saying it's here. Okay. Yeah. No. Once I've done the main quest stuff, I'll be calling it a playthrough. But in the future, I will be using a different setup. I will be playing Morrowind again at some point. I'll be using a different setup, different mods, and I will use Tamriel Rebuilt. I think I might use Ashfall as well in the next playthrough. I'm here! Sorry I missed you. I had to run some old documents over to the Inquisitor at the Ministry of Truth. I'm likely to be tied up there for a while. Oh dear. Why don't you meet me there as soon as you can? Then we can leave together as soon as I'm done. And am I. Don't forget to bring me the two Divine Intervention scrolls you borrowed. Or if you use them, buy a couple of new ones for me. I think I'm going to need them soon. Janand Molini at the Mage's Guild in the Foreign Quarter keeps them in stock. Alvela Saram is the guard at the entrance. Just tell her you're looking for me and she'll let you in. Your faithful friend, Mera. P.S. I left a couple of levitate potions here for you, just in case. Couldn't remember if you knew the spell or not, so I drew a couple from stock. Oh, is it the Skyrim mod for Morrowind? Ooh. Yeah, I'm always open to suggestions, so yeah, I'll look into it and looks like I borrowed the scrolls previously. Okay. Yeah, I'm lost again. Yeah, so I'll be looking into what I can do for next time. I mean, if you've seen what I've got in store for you poor, poor souls, you'll know that I definitely don't have a problem with trying out different mods. Anyway, while I'm at it, and a few more people have turned up, evidently, it's time to once again toot my own horn and say I finally managed to reach 100 followers on Twitch, which is awesome. Thank you everyone for following. I'm quite excited, but now we have a new goal. A new goal to become a corporate shill. and reach the lofty heights of 250 followers. And yes, thank you very much, philosopher. It's kind of surprising that I managed to get 100 followers in under 7 months. Considering that I don't really do too much in the way of promotion, I promote my VODs and my streams in other people's Discords. In the appropriate places and in the appropriate manner, of course. I'm not going to step on anyone's toes just to get my name out there. But that's pretty much the extent of all the self-promotion I do. And to have reached 100 followers on Twitch and the nice number of subscribers on YouTube, I'm pretty excited about it. But now I've got my eyes on 250. Oh, we need to go to the Mage's Guild. The Mage's Guild, I need to go up. More. So yes, I need to reach 250 followers if I want to embrace the corporate shill life, as another fellow streamer, the Omega Paladin, had mentioned it to me, that there is a place where I can get in contact with developers and such, and potentially get like sponsorship deals and the like with them. And one of the requirements is 250 followers. Right, finally, I'm here. Another person I've been told to see about getting divine intervention scrolls. Scrolls of divine intervention. You have exactly two. Okay. Oh, but you buy things as well. I want the Amulet of Health. The Amulet of Shadows is kind of nice. Amulet of Slow Falling. I'll keep just in case, but I tend to forget I have that. You can have the Blood Belt. I want the Glove of Divinity because I just want a pair of divine gloves. Keeping Hercene's Ring. Don't really need that. Command Humanoid. Not really useful at this point in the game. Restore Fatigue for 30 seconds. Might be useful. And yeah, get rid of that. Oh. And... okay, well, is there any other... ooh. Yeah, I'll take that invisibility scroll. Anything else here? Ooh. Yeah, I'll take that as well. If I buy one more thing... I might be able to break even or get close to it. Nah, it's fine. I'll go with that. Oh dear, I managed to... oh, that's rough, philosopher. Yeah, I've had that happen a number of times with Skyrim, where I've... modded it so much that one thing broke it and caused something of a cascade. I think it was worse with Oblivion. I think there was one instance where I managed to mod the game so much and then forgot which mods I had added when and where. And then, of course, me being me, I had to spend the next, I think it was 12 hours, trying to diagnose the issue. Yeah, Skyrim's a little bit more finicky because there's just more systems at play. I know it's hard to believe sometimes, but can I make that jump? Well, no guts, no glory, right? Sploosh. There we go. Oh dear. See, there are aspects of Morrowind Rebirth that I'm happy with. Like extending the cities, or the towns, like that bit at the north of Vivec, and pretty much redoing Ebonheart, are really nice additions to the world, but yeah, Rebirth messes with a lot of balancing, and I'm not such a big fan of the direction they took those changes. Modding test games makes you feel really blind after working with Unreal. You know, I haven't really done a lot with the Unreal engines. Back in the days of Unreal Tournament, the classic Unreal Tournament, I dabbled a little bit with the engine, but not a whole lot. I must admit that I'm not the brightest when it comes to technical aspects. I mean, just take a look at this. I'm spending way too long looking for the word levitate. So imagine that when trying to debug my own spaghetti code. Doop-be-doo. Do I go in here? No. Do I go up here? Possibly. Maybe I need permission to be up here. I can't remember.
Where's that slave? Here not long ago.
I'm sorry, no pilgrims allowed in the ministry. I'll have to ask you to leave, but you're not here to visit anyone, are you? Well, when you should say that. Mera said you would come. I'll say you subdued me with magic and stole my key. It opens all three exterior doors. The upper back door is the best. You need the other keys for other doors inside. Search for keys in the desks. No one carries keys while on duty. There is in a prison keep in the cell on the far right. Mera said you'd bring some scrolls to get out. Some of us are sympathetic to the dissident priests, but kill an ordinator and you'll lose that sympathy. Here's the key to that to the entrance. Get going. Yeah, no problem, philosopher. Now, time to do a bit of a break-in. Upper back. Well, is this the front or the back? Oh, welcome back. Oh. I was working on a thing to play D&D online through for 3D maps and the works. The main thing is that when something goes wrong, you have to have the tools to figure out what went wrong. Yeah, you don't have the same tools with... well, you don't have the same official tools with the Elder Scrolls games. But... there are unofficial debugging tools. Things like Rybash or Wirebash. I can never remember what it's called. No idea where I'm supposed to be going. Rybash or Wirebash is really good for debugging mods and resolving mod conflicts. And I think the Morrowind version of it is not Bash but Mash. Okay. They really weren't expecting people to break in up here if the lock level is 10. Oh boy. Okay. Let's, you know what? Let's see if we can just sneak by. Need to go into the cell on the far right. Well, if this was Skyrim, I could crouch jump here. The longer I take around here, the more likely they are to spot me, so... cell on the far right. Doink. Sneaky, sneaky, sneak.
Is there something I can do
for you? Fancy seeing you here. Might I play a Total War game? Maybe. It's been a while since I've played a Total War game, like, properly. And these days, I'm mostly interested in playing Total War Warhammer 3, but the loading times for that game really don't make it that good for something to stream with. I mean, maybe a little way down the line when I've got a better setup and I've got more people more people in chat chatting away and people I can chat with, so then I'd have something I could pass the time with, and then yeah, I could play Total War Warhammer 3, because well, then I can chat while waiting between turns and loading screens. But, yeah, it has crossed my mind to play a Total War game again, and to do it on stream. Right, do you have the Divine Intervention scrolls? I have an escape plan. I had a feeling that was your plan for escape. I'll need one Divine Intervention scroll myself for my escape plan. Getting out will be a lot faster and safer for you if you have one. But if you haven't got one for yourself, maybe you can find some other way out. Now, listen, here's my plan. Give me a Divine Intervention scroll. I'll meet you at the secret dissident priest's monastery at Holomayan. For safety, we'll travel separately. Okay. When you get out of here, look for a woman named Blatter Hateria on the east dock of Ebonheart. Tell her I sent you that you want to go fishing. Yeah, she'll bring you to Holomayan by boat. I'll meet you there, and we'll get the lost prophecies from Gilvis Barello, the leader of the dissident priests. And magic conceals the Holomayan entrance. Speak to Vivrana Arian, a monk at the dock of Holomayan, about the hidden entrance. I think we've been here, actually. Accidentally. Okay. Yep. Okay. Yep. Yep. Divine Intervention scrolls. I have the scroll. Okay. That's good. I'm fine, thank you. What can I do for you? You're taking this in your stride, aren't you? Right. Now. Scroll of Divine Intervention.
Where's that slave?
My trusty lockpick. Let's remove that for now. Right. Yeah, Medieval 2 is... I haven't played that game in a long, long time. I think I have a similar relationship with... Rome Total War and Medieval 2 Total War that I do with Daggerfall and Morrowind. I do think Medieval 2 is the better game, but Rome Total War... Maybe it's because Rome Total War was my first Total War game, and I have that sort of nostalgia for it. But I don't know, there's something really fun about Rome Total War, the original Rome Total War. I've seen the remastered Rome Total War, and I don't know, it felt kind of off. I mean, it feels the remaster of Rome Total War to me feels like encountering your girlfriend. Or boyfriend, if that's your inclination. And noticing something is not right about them. And it turns out that they've been replaced by some kind of alien. that's masquerading as your boyfriend or girlfriend. That's how the remastered Rome Total War feels to me. Right, Blatter! Hello! Hello, I'm Blatter. Terrier, do I know you? Right, you're Spanx the Wayward. My friend said you might want to go fishing. Yes, I do want to go fishing. I know a fine place. Excellent fishing, my friend. Mara Miller says it's her favourite fishing spot. You ready to go? Yes. Good. Ready to take you to Holomayan. Yeah, anytime you're ready to travel. I'll be here to offer that service anytime you need it. Excellent. Looks like I have to pay for the service. Whatever. There we go. And it's night time once again. I'm Vavrana Arian, a monk of Holomayan. The monastery is here on this island. Take the stone pathway north from the docks and the path uphill. The entrance is hidden by a magical shield. Wait or rest at the head of the path. And the portal will open at dusk and dawn only. The magical twilight hours are sacred to Azura. Mayor Amilo has told us of your coming. You can find her in the library with Master Borello. Later I can arrange for your return to Vivek, whenever you're ready.
Thank you. Is there something you need?
Yeah, I want to get into the temple, but you've just told me how to do that, so nothing else. Thank you. Goodbye. Ah, I remember this. Ah, dear. So we have to wait for twilight hours. Oh, of course. How did you get here? Silly Guar. I'll take your meats. In fact, I'll take your meats and use them to make a potion. Now, which one is it? There we go. There. And just got it. Well, just this wild Guar comes along, wakes me up, tries to eat me. I punch it in the face a few times, gut it, and then eat it. Is that irony? Anyway, that's enough of that. 3 a.m. Okay, well, I better quick save here because this is where it starts getting weird. What does the game consider twilight hours? We're getting close to them twilight hours. I don't remember the god rays being quite like this before. That is quite an unusual effect that we've got going on there. But there we go. So 6 a.m. is twilight hours. Well, here we are. Mayor Amilo. Gilvis Borello. Fantastic. Thank you, Spanx the Wayward, for rescuing me. Now I'll stay here at Holomayan with Master Borello and assist him with the monastery's library. Okay. Gilvis Borello has is the abbot of our monastery and the head of our secret order. We have adopted the name Dissident Priests. We're not ashamed of our disputes with the temple's hierarchy. We are fiercely loyal to the temple's ancient traditions, but we are troubled that the ultimate source of the tribunal's divinity might be the same as the source of Dagothur's evil power. Dagothur's power seems to wax as the tribunal's power wanes. Read the Progress of Truth and other documents of the Apocrypha in our library, and you'll see why we are uneasy. Right, okay. How can I help you? What can you tell me about the Lost Prophecies? I've reviewed the Apocrypha and found two passages of particular interest. I've made copies of these passages to give to you. Many are familiar with the two Nerevering prophecies current among the Ashlanders called the Stranger and the Seven Vision. We have two other prophecies, the Lost Prophecy and the Seven Curses, that may offer additional insights into the riddles surrounding the coming of the Incarnate. Perhaps these are the Lost Prophecies that your friend Ebony Mesa has told you about. We've also prepared a document for you called Kagranak's Tools. This document will explain to you and to others the terrible secret that the temple conceals about the true history of the tribunal and the corrupt nature of their divine powers. It is to conceal the secret that the temple persecutes the Nerevarine and the dissident priests. This persecution must stop. We must unite against the true enemy, Dagothur. And if you're the Nerevarine, you must lead us against him. Oh boy. So, people are talking about the Apocrypha. The Hierographer are collected priestly writings of the temple. The Apocrypha are the hidden writings. Secrets known only to the highest levels of the priesthood and Inquisition. Defying the temple, we have gathered as much of the Apocrypha as we can here in Holomeion. One of the chief disputes between the temple and the dissident priests is that the temple hides the truth from its followers. Oh dear, this is starting to sound like someone is about to nail a treatise to the door of a church. Anyway, the Lost Prophecy. From the seventh sign of the 11th generation, neither Hound nor Gwar nor Sea nor Harrow, but Dragonborn and Farstar marked. Outlander incarnate beneath Red Mountain, blessed guest, counters seven curses. Star-blessed hands wields thrice-cursed blade to recap the harvest of the unmourned house. I've annotated your copy of the Lost Prophecy with our best efforts at interpretation, but a rough summary might be an outlander foreign-born, but welcomed as a guest, confronts seven curses beneath Red Mountain. His hand, blessed by Azura, uses a cursed blade to bring justice to House Dagoth, or House Dwemer, or both. The Nerevarine, an honest... an outlander? That wouldn't please many Ashlanders, and may explain how the prophecy got lost. It's Tubes. 69 Theses. Yeah, indeed. Although with his... rather gruff voice, I think it's less 69, more 420 Theses. Right, the Seven Curses. Reads as follows. Through the doors of the unmourned house where scoffers scoff and schemers scheme, from the halls of the oath-breaking house rings seven curses of gods blasphemed. First curse, Curse of fire. Second curse of ash. Third curse of flesh. Fourth curse of ghosts. Fifth curse of seeds. Sixth curse of despair. Seventh curse of dreams. Oh boy. Your copy of the Seven Curses bears our guesses at interpreting the verses. In short form, the Seven Curses come from House Dagoth or House Dwemer or both. Fire and ash come from the Red Mountain. Flesh is corporous. Ghost, seed, and despair are unclear, but Curse of Dream seems to refer to the recent cases of soul sickness and sleeper attacks in the towns. Okay, what else have we been talking about here? Don't really need anything else, although... Let's see what you have to say about the Nerevrine. Our interest in the Nerevrine used to be a matter of principle, a willingness to consider the validity of mystical insights rejected by temple doctrine. Now, Dagoth grows stronger while the tribunal grows weaker. And the return of Saint Nerevar, even if only reborn in spirit, may be our best prospect of salvation. And Dagoth. So long as the Ordinator's buoyant armatures and tribunal could contain the Blight and Dagoth's creatures within the ghost fence, faith in the temple's protective power was strong. But now travellers and settlements suffer from blight storms and marauding monsters. And the people fear the temple is losing its age-old battle with Devil Dagoth. Right. Nerevar. Ooh. Added more things for me. By the way, here are a few books from our library you might find of interest. Each gives a very different impression of Nerevar. The real Nerevar, Nerevar Moon and Star, and Saint Nerevar. Interesting. I'm guessing Saint Nerevar may be the temple's view? Nerevar Moon and Star, I believe, is the Ashlander's take, and the real Nerevar is probably a more cynical outsider's perspective. So, what can you tell me about Mehra? I've been helping her out recently, but don't really know her all that much. She's run terrible risks remaining at the Hall of Wisdom and Truth, and we're grateful that you rescued her from the Ministry of Truth. Okay, well, guess there's not much else to say about her then. Okay, so returning to Vivek. We've run Arion, the monk at the docks outside, can arrange for travel back to Vivek. Okay. So, yeah, just general hospitality rules and stuff we already know about, basically. No taking taxes from these guys. What's a Nord doing here?
You've got the better of me, so go ahead.
Okay, well, I'm not going to question it any further. Right, well, I'm getting out of here before the door closes again. And I guess it's time to go... I guess, actually, we need to go back to, Mesa. In that case, rather than paying to go back to Vivek, we'll just use some recall spell. Now that we know where that goes.
You didn't find
me worthy of your attention.
You've changed your tune since we first met. Go ahead. Do you have questions about the Nerevarine prophecies? Or other questions to ask me? Do you bring me news of the lost prophecies? Hear about the prophecies. You have these lost prophecies? You will tell me these things over and over until I have them by heart. And then you will tell me what these priests say. What they say, see in these words, and then you must leave me. Hunt, sleep, train, feed. Learn the land. Just bring these things into me and place them before my ancestors and listen to them. And to the skies and stars of my dreams. And then, when the moons have come and gone, return. And I will give you my judgment. Okay, so we have to wait a while. Well, for the first time since first discovering this camp, it's not actually stormy. Nice. But that's going to have to be it for this session. I'd like to thank you all for joining me, and for those of you on YouTube, take care and have fun.